next question is from Sue Matthews of Scriba. Sue, do you want me to read your question for you? And we are starting with Anne Marie on this one. If you couldn't vote for yourself, which remaining candidate would you choose and why?
Vote for Ursula because she got herself on the ballot and got herself did the petition process with the Green Party and has had the courage and the conviction to stand up and talk about what she believes and what she, you know, and I have to give her a lot of credit for that and to be accountable to the voters and to be willing to come into, you know, these four town halls that we planned with a willingness to say, you know, we probably don't agree on a lot of things, but we're willing to stand here in front of you and tell you what we think, what we believe, and how we would legislate. Having said that, I do think that I'm the best candidate. I think that if I'm asking for your vote and your support, I have to make the case for myself, which I, that's what we're doing here tonight, making the case to Oswego County. But my beliefs are ones that I think are most consistent with the Constitution, with the vision of our forefathers, with why we, this country was even formed back in the 1700s, that we are endowed by our Creator with rights, unalienable rights, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, and it's incumbent upon the legislators to really understand the proper role of government, understand the role that government should have in our lives, whether it's national security, infrastructure, education, very important function of the government, but to understand that the government, especially the federal government, has a proper role. And I think it's important for the legislature to understand what that role should be. And I think that's what I do best. Thank you.
Is that why you have this group? Because of that, by forcing your religious beliefs on
everybody. I'm sorry, sir. We have to keep our comments to the question sheets.
We only have an hour, so we have a legitimate question. I mean, really. Talk about issues. What candidate would you vote for? You, I mean, we all know. I mean, let's have a legitimate question. Not waste the hour.
The questions are drawn at random, and all right, okay. It's just the luck of the draw.
Okay.
So I answered with Thrace because I was basically looking at the choices on the ballot and picking myself. How could any principled person, progressive person, a person of conscience that cares about the future of our country, the future of the planet, vote for either candidates that represent the leadership of their parties who I think have just been busy fighting each other and not working for solutions to the serious problems we're facing? So honestly, if I was going to vote for myself, like many other people that are going to vote for me, I probably wouldn't be voting in this race on Election Day.
I just want to prove I can't see the questions, they're folded in half. Emily Matherson, would you like me to ask your question for you? Okay. Please explain the difference in your Medicare plan and Democratic plan. What is your position on additional nuclear power plants in Oswego County and transportation of children to schools in case of accident or terrorist attack and solution of disposal of the waste? And we are starting with Ursula this morning.
Yeah, great. Those are two questions about issues that I'm very concerned with and care about. So there's a big difference between the recent healthcare reform that we saw and my plan. I support Medicare for All plan. That gives us the freedom to choose our doctors, the freedom to choose where we get healthcare, because it cuts insurance companies out. I think that's the biggest problem right now, driving up costs in our healthcare system, are the healthcare companies that are basically profiting off our illnesses. And so I would support a Medicare for All system that basically lowers the eligibility age to Medicare to zero and gives everyone equal coverage. not equal coverage, but affordable coverage, similar coverage. And I think it's really important to, you know, look at the Affordable Care Act and not repeal it, because, but to move forward to a single payer system, which has been, many studies have shown this kind of a healthcare system is much more cost effective. I think there was a study that in 2009 from the Patterson administration saying that single payer healthcare in New York State would be the most efficient way to provide healthcare to everyone. And we know that rising healthcare costs are going to be a serious problem down the line. And so we can figure out a way to stabilize them. And I think there was a second question there about nuclear power. So can you read that one again?
What is your position on additional nuclear power plants in Stewart County and the transportation of children from schools in case of accident or terrorist attacks as a solution for disposal of waste?
Well, I think that my position against any new nuclear power plants would be that we should not have any more nuclear power plants, and we need a plan to phase out the current plants. And we need to have a plan for how can we justly help workers maintain their benefits and transition to new jobs, because we know that there's no level of nuclear radiation that's safe. Nuclear energy is very expensive. It's a mature industry that has been relying on taxpayer subsidies for far too long. There's radioactive water. There's tritium leaking out of 9 Mile 1 right now, and they can't identify the source of the leak. And there is no safe way to store nuclear waste in the long term. And so I think the last thing we want to see is an accident like what we saw in Fukushima a couple years ago. So we need to figure out how can we transition to safe, renewable, sustainable energy, and how can we do that in a way so that folks that are working in the nuclear industry now can also maintain their employment.
The first issue about Medicare, unless we are willing as a nation to look at Medicare is not sustainable. It's not in a sustainable course, and it really is immoral for us not to understand that. And so I think what you've seen in proposed budgets is a willingness to look at Medicare, not for those who are 55 and older, but for those who are younger, give them choices to hopefully keep Medicare alive and well for generations to come. The Affordable Care Act, which I am opposed to because of what it does, I'm opposed to on a lot of levels, but it cuts Medicare by $716 billion. And if you don't think that is going to affect the coverage for the seniors, the current seniors who are receiving Medicare, then you really need to look closely at the Affordable Care Act. We've already heard from physicians and hospitals who are concerned about these cuts, who are also going to be cut as a result of sequestration, and they are very, very concerned that they cannot support as many Medicare patients as they would like. My opponent talks about Medicare system for all. The question is, who's going to pay for it?
Right.
Who is going to pay for it? This nation is $16 trillion in debt. We have no plan to address that debt. You talk about immoral. Immoral is giving that debt to our kids and generations to come. That's not America. I do want to say, Ursula made a comment about not voting. We have men and women who are dying on the fields in Afghanistan and Iraq, giving the ultimate sacrifice so that we can all walk into a voting booth on November the 6th and cast a ballot for someone. And they deserve, they take an oath to uphold the Constitution, and the very least we can do is doing what you're here tonight, becoming informed electorates, being a part of the political process, and understanding and appreciating the sacrifice they make. So we have the privilege of voting on November 6th. I think that's one of the most important, responsible things that we can do as citizens. With regards to nuclear power, I think nuclear power is safe. I think nuclear energy should be developed. I think that, you know, I met just 2 days ago with the folks from Constellation. They are self-regulating. They're making sure that their facilities are safe. Those are good jobs. They provide a substantial amount of electricity as opposed to wind and power and solar, which only account for about 2% of electricity. I think we should be encouraging that. And to say that what happened at Fukushima is, Fukushima was not current. It was not self-regulated. It was not up to the standards that it should have been, and was not could not withstand a tsunami along with an earthquake. And to equate that to Nine Mile or to Guinea's, I think irresponsible. I think nuclear power is safe, and I think it's should be developed. Sir, please, we ask that everyone... That will be our next step, is we will have to have you removed. We need to follow the format so we can get through the questions.
Well, are people making noise when they're clapping their hands?
No, we're getting rid
of that. That's out of respect.
All right, we're moving along. The next question is from Valerie. And I'm sorry, I'm having a difficult time reading your last name from the city of Oswego. Valerie, are you here? Would you like me to read your question for you? Okay. All right, the questions are, I'm gonna skip over the first one because it asks about climate change, which I think we've probably already covered with the global warming. Her second question is, do you feel fracking is a good economic investment? See, the third is, do you feel people should be encouraged to grow their own food? And do you feel it is important to have genetically modified foods labeled? With regards to fracking, the reality about fracking is that's a state issue, as we've seen with the governor. That is really not something that we have anything to do with on the federal level. It is a decision that the states make, which is the appropriate way to go. We have an energy and environmental panel. We have Dr. From ESF, Dr. Murphy.